I don't know my dinosaurs very well, but we're at another entrance. We're going in the gate. We're going to go to the visitor center first. This is Dory. And I think it says Apatosaurus. I swear I thought she was a brontosaurus. I don't know my dinosaurs, but let's get in the park.
Good afternoon.
Hello, dinosaur. Here you go.
Thank you, sir.
You're all set. Have a good day.
All right, here we go. All right, going into the visitor center. Dinosaur National Monument. Okay, we're headed to the Quarry Exhibit Hall. So basically, like Mammoth Site, they built this structure over the findings, right? In fact, at one point, the ground was not stable and they had to rebuild. So this is rebuilt. But let's get inside and check it out. Wow, 65 million years ago. 95 million years ago, shallow seas cover Utah. Wow, all these interesting facts. 140 million years ago, flowering plants evolve. 150 million years ago, sauropod dinosaurs dominate the Morrison environment. Thank you, sir. Hello. Where you stand today, an ancient river flowed swiftly across a vast plain. Then a long drought killed many dinosaurs. Some dinosaur bodies lay near and in the dry river channel. Look at all those bones. Even as high up as up there. I guess we can go down to that ground level, huh? Showing them in the excavation process. The building of this building. You can take a shuttle up here. They recommend that because there's only limited parking spaces. That's the parking area right there. Okay, so where did all the bones go? You see there's the Allosaurus is in Carnegie Museum. So is the Camptosaurus. Diplodocus is in Denver. Apatosaurus in Carnegie also. Stegosaurus in Nebraska. Oh, see, that gives us another reason to go back to Nebraska. Camarasaurus in Smithsonian in Washington, D.C. Barosaurus in Toronto. That Carnegie's got a lot too. Dryosaurus, Barosaurus, and Diplosaurus. Okay, so you gotta go to the American Museum for that one. Smithsonian in D.C. Pretty cool. So paleontologists have collected fossils from almost 400 different dinosaurs. And there are 1,500 fossil bones remaining. They're from 100 different individuals. Wow. Well, how'd they know to make the building stop right here,
right,
and not continue it on out?
And like how they know what's behind this slab, because look at how much is on the behind.
Look at that fish one. Is that a fish one? Oh. It certainly looks like one. I don't know either. What animals have been found in the quarry? All of these. The most common dinosaur in the quarry was the Camarasaurus. Camarasaurus. All right, it's time to head downstairs. Even though I still hear that crying, baby. All right, now we're downstairs with the bones. The bones we can touch. This is a Camarasaurus femur, adult right thigh bone. 149 million years ago is its origin from a Camarasaurus. Massive bone. Wow. I'm touching dinosaur bone. Oh, and there's your Camarasaurus. Juvenile skeleton. Okay. Look at the comparison. Your own femur. An adult Camarasaurus's femur height would be 57 inches. So this is a child Camarasaurus. That's crazy. Oh, look at that. These casts are fragile. Do not touch. You can touch real dinosaur fossils on the quarry wall. This is the Camarasaurus body. Okay. That's pretty cool. Okay, now the Allosaurus. Skull, left side, outer surface. Huh. It's from 155 million years ago. This is one of the most complete meat-eating dinosaur skeletons ever found in Lake Jurassic Park. And that's them discovering 1990. Wow, that's when they discovered it. How cool is that? It's a little mangled looking to me, but... extra challenge they have. The rocks of the Morrison Formation are full of dinosaur bones and are also relatively unstable. Look, at one point they had to fix this building, just like I said, in 2006. Problems began soon after the hall was built. By 1967, columns and walls began to crack. The building was designated a National Historic Landmark in 2001, but by 2006, the building was at risk of collapsing. The National Park Service closed it that July. And then 2011, major rehabilitation of the quarry hall was completed in 2011. New columns extend deep into the solid rock below the quarry. This provides a firm foundation for the building. Well, that makes me feel better. They have cute little benches here. Nice wall. And they have these little magnifying glass things that you can look through and see the life that's on the ground. Insects and plants, life in the ponds and lakes, really cool stuff. Touch a real dinosaur, but don't climb on them. Pretty neat. They have it down on a lower level, you see, because we were up there before. Looking down at all of this. The dinosaur bones are 149 million years old. These bones are fragile, and so are yours. All right. This is going to wrap it up. This is the end of the fossils here in this section. Very neat. This here is an Allosaurus. Crazy. Yikes. And that's his head. Allosaurus skull, intact and in shape. I guess that's what his footprints would look like. All right. Let's get out of here, Jimbo. All these dinosaurs are creeping me out.